controlled much of the last quarter. All of a sudden, North hit the front, but lovely piece of play. Now, somebody who will be a key part of 11-16 SEN again in 2010 is former AFL coach and a man with an eye for an interesting game, Robert Shaw. Good evening, Robert.
Evenings with Mark Fine. Have you, beauty. How are you?
Good, mate. Now, this was a club that you were involved with,
yep.
The Fremantle Dockers.
Yeah.
And interestingly, they played with a freedom and ball movement that, to me, I know it's only a NAB Cup game, and I'm not saying they're going to be a great team, but I've got to say, they certainly looked a lot better to me lifting their eyes and looking for the best option rather than kicking blindly to Matthew Pavlich, who didn't play.
Well, he didn't play, and you're quite right. They kept persevering with young Ryan Murphy, that in the end kicked a winning goal. And there was a lot to like about them. There was a lot to like about both sides, I think. The Kangaroos probably, maybe inexperienced, I guess, with the euphoric win of last week, just off the boil fractionally, and sort of Fremantle with they've had a very poor record at Eddie Head Stadium, and the number of players that are out of that side gives them a lot of hope. And you're right, a lot of persistence. Their tackling was very good, and if you ever wanted an image to show your team, a young team, a school team, a kids team, of what to do when there's about 30 seconds to go and you need to score, I think the setup that they did with the kick from Tarrant to Sandilands, the knock on, it was just copybook, and they persisted and they kept the ball going forward and showed really good composure. So there's a bit to like about them, there's no doubt about that, and some very good players to come back into that side.
I agree. I think any team that trails by a couple of points with 30 seconds to go should kick the ball, as long as they've got a 7-foot mobile ruckman, kick it to him.
Well, it was pretty handy. That's
the man to go to.
I think there was one game plan, but the execution of it was fantastic. And it looked, I watched it on telly because it was a wonderful afternoon on Sunday. You had the 2020, then watching my boys, Tassie.
So I'll get enough from Jeffrey Polder this week.
I
want to ask you something about that last goal quickly.
Yep.
Name me the key players in that last goal.
Well, the experience of Tarrant. It was a gimme. You, me, anyone would have known they had to go down. So the positioning of Sandilands and the positioning of the boys around it. Ballantyne was absolutely critical because he had to make the final decision with some North players coming on to him. And I must admit, you probably got me for a couple of blokes.
The one guy is this boy Hill. Look, I know he can run. I know he can kick. We know he's got talent, but his composure and his tackling ability there, just watch this space on this boy.
Yeah, and he's put on his 5 or 6. I spoke to Harves about him. We saw him last year very thin coming out of the under-18 competition. He's done what they normally do, and they pump them up at this time. You know, he's put on the 5 or 7 kilos, but looks as though he could really develop. I'm not sure whether they're going to play him. He's a natural winger. He has kicked goals, and they like him at half-back, so... And I guess young Ballantyne from Peel Thunder, it's going to be very, very hard to replace Geoffrey Farmer, of course. But, gee, he had 10 tackles, he's tenacious, and they played very well. And